out in the pits here at the NHRA, found an amazing Hemi car, and found a driver too, Jason Line, Hemi Challenge. That's pretty cool. What brings you back into this?
You throw that word out loosely.
What, Jason Line?
No, driver.
Driver. Yeah. What the self-deprecating humor is back.
Yeah, some things don't change. Well, Bucky asked me to drive it because I guess he needed a driver. So he asked me to drive it. So why not? It's a cool car. It's a Hemi. It's the U.S. Nationals. Why wouldn't you?
All right. So we're here because the car is amazing, and we love the paintwork by Tukey. Really, every car that we've ever featured, we're featuring this car. But what's it like to drive this particular one?
Frightening. Yeah, you're scared to scratch it. Like it's, I mean, it's beautiful. Obviously, it's a work of art. And
are you leaning on the car right now? Is that okay?
I am, actually, but I have very soft clothing on. So it's nothing compared to what I did do earlier. So, yeah, it is a little scary because it's working on it. You know, you don't want to scratch it. Like, it's really, I mean, it's a beautiful car. It's a work of art.
Okay, how is it to drive? Because I know you guys came to win the Sox Martin Hemi Challenge. Beautiful car. All the best of the world are here to do this. What are your chances?
I don't know. I mean, I think they're decent. So, yeah, I mean, the car's, it's good. It's really good. We that's the first run we made with the car that it actually didn't get down the racetrack. So we were directionally correct. Now, we hung a left there for some reason. But we'll figure it out. And we definitely have a good chance. It's a great car, and we'll fix it for tomorrow.
You're a three-time Pro Stock World Champion, one in Stock Eliminator as well. But I think directionally correct is your legacy in NHRA drag racing. Everybody uses that.
Yeah, maybe, yeah. Well, it's fitting, so.
All right, well, we know you got to go. Jason Line with us. Let's talk to the guys who made this happen. And so let's bring in the guys who are responsible for this amazing work of art, Travis and Bucky Hess. This is not the first time we've done this bit with these guys, but they have rolled out another amazing machine, Travis, the fish stick. Is it the fish stick or is it just fish stick?
I think just fish stick.
You're trying to get the announcers in trouble with this one, yeah. But okay. This is as insane as any of your works. We've seen the Psycho Cuda. We've seen the Candy Cuda. We've seen High Anxiety. How many hours of work went into Fish Stick?
Well, it's 4 or 5 weeks straight. So, I mean, from sealer up, probably 250 couple hours. I mean, I lose track, but I know about average 250, 260. And just the paint part and the lettering and gold leaf. Well, you know, so it's all hand painted.
Well, you're going to take us around the car in a minute, but Bucky, what are you more proud of? I probably ask you this every time. The car and the paint, or your child that's able to do this?
How could you not be proud of this boy? I mean, he's the most talented artist, especially, and, you know, to bring back the funny car of the 60s and 70s, you know, for him to have that inspiration and take it twice as good, you know, it's, and, you know, he's a craftsman, he's a specialist, everything's got to be perfect. Like, all them circles on that gold leaf's got to be perfect. He's just that, you know, and how could you not be proud of that? His mother and I are just, you know, we couldn't be, and I know his wife's just as proud of him, too.
And I know you came to win the Sox and Martin Hemi Challenge, though. It's not just about being pretty. You got a fast car, and you got a good driver. Tell us real quick the whole Jason Line situation. How did this come together?
Well, I mean, I know how good Jason's motors are, and I know a stick car, you know, it's 5 to 10th faster than an automatic. So all these stick cars, everybody went stick car. There's a reason, because they're faster. So I wanted to prove a point that our motors are faster than them. Even though I'm in automatic, he's in the stick, we're going to make this thing real fast. So for like the 8th run, the run of 46, that's pretty impressive here, 108 correction factor.
Amazing. All right, Travis Hess, a.k.a. Tukey. Follow him on Instagram. Please walk us around this car and just show us some of the effects that you did and what went into them, because this is probably hours of effort, but we'll let the camera lead the way. And Travis, you just show us some of the things that took a lot of time.
Well, I mean, I'm influenced by a lot of the old California painters from 60s and 70s, the funny car guys, Bill Carter, and, you know, back east, Glenn Weisgerber, and my mentor Nelson Grimes got me into focus on gold leaf and lettering. And so basically this fingerprint stuff, if you look at it, that's why it got its name. It really resembles a fingerprint. And then we got the fish scales. Obviously, that's a no-brainer, a Barracuda. And, you know, it's a little redundant, but we've always, it's kind of been a thing for Dad's cars to have fish scales since the second car, you know, and flames. So it's just kind of our theme, you know. Some guys are like, oh, it's the same thing, but it's our cars, so you know what I mean. That's what we do. But
wait. You know, wait. People are like offering up some sort of negativity towards this.
Well, one particular racer, I won't mention any names, but yeah, he's got nothing good to say. But we forgive him. It's no big deal.
That's it. Everybody's got their personality quirks. Right. Now the flames on the top, the flames on the hood. It pops so much. The color choices, though, you make it work. If you told me that we would have gold and yellow and red and purple and gold leaf, I don't know if you'd be able to make it work, but you made it work. It works great.
Thanks. I get that a lot. A lot of people are like, there's no way I would have ever thought to put those two, you know, and I like I said, I study the old masters and then I just try to put my take on it. I mean, it's kind of silly to put this much time into a race car. I'm really influenced by the 60s, 70s lowrider guys out west. So this, if you put this same paint job on a 65 Impala that's now a lowrider, this just happens to be a 68 Cuda drag car. So yeah, we pray, you know, nothing bad goes, you know, but it's just a race car. It's a show car for a race or two, and then it's all business. They're going to get chipped. They're going to get banged up. You just try your best not to. But anyways, Jason and them, they're all business, you know. Like, I'm the guy over here. I'll wipe them off a little. They just want to go fast, and I get it. I like to do both. That's, you know, we're trying to sell paint jobs, and it's my passion. I don't just I live it. I study it. That's just what I am. It's all I know. So I'm passionate. I want them to look good and go fast. I mean, in the 60s, you had, you know, Bill Mazzolini, you know, all those guys. They had pretty cars, but they were fast. Candy red, gold leaf, you know, all the gassers back then. They paid Bill Carter. They paid Tom Kelly. Kenny Youngblood, they wanted them to look good because that's your trademark. That guy is fast and it's pretty, you know. So I'm just trying to keep that alive, you know.
Well, you're doing a great job. Anything hidden in this paint scheme? I know you've done some of that in the past, and I'm overwhelmed, folks. Show me some stuff.
Just some pearl highlights, you know, if you look. Just some hot spots. You just take the metal flick, obviously, and then you do the candies and then hit some of the highlights with pearls and just some ghosted highlights in here, and that's all just layering, you know. And you just got to know what colors are going to make, because like, so these scales are blue, but then you put the candy pink over it and then it makes a purple, you know. You got to think kind of backwards. That's just how candies work. And then just many hours later you end up with something.
and did you draw this out first? And
so I'm not really any chip foose with the renderings or anything, but I just do a quick map just so I know what colors are going where, and then I just build off the sketch and just improvise as I go.
Well, congratulations on another work of art. Folks, you got to follow him on Instagram, but this is an amazing car. Thank you for sharing it with us, Travis.
Thanks a lot, Joe. Appreciate it.
And that's why you come out into the pits here at the NHRA.